Hallo, ich bin Tobias von Base 58 und heute habe ich zu Gast Marjan Delatin von Ripple. Und ja, ich bin sehr gespannt, was sie mir heute erzählen kann über Ripple. Hi Marjan, thanks for joining us. And you joined Ripple in April last year, is that right?
Yes, indeed. Yeah. Thanks, Tobias, for initiating this discussion with Ripple.
Yeah, what was your motivation to join Ripple?
Disruption.
Disruption, okay, great.
I was very much interested in the vision of Ripple, which is around the Internet of Value. And I think that's really addressing the current pain points that the cross-border space is living. So yeah. I adhered actually to this vision.
Yeah, cool. And before you were working at Swift, which is kind of competitor to Ripple, so it's a distinctive decision to switch from Swift to Ripple. And now I have the impression both Swift and Ripple are not quite sure whether to be competitors and to wall off, or rather collaborate and build something together. You know both very well, so what's your opinion on that?
I personally think that Ripple and Swift are doing different things. It's true that at the end we are talking about transferring value, but Swift is a messaging mechanism. Mm. Of course, it's widely present with the large users, but it remains only to the exchange of data. But when you get to the blockchain and what Ripple is doing, you are going beyond that exchange of data. You are actually settling value. You are providing the finality and certainty of the payment. So I think it could be very much complementary. Now, probably it takes time before the business lines can meet each other. But I think we are doing different things in this space.
But isn't the Ripple approach a superset then of what Swift is doing, and would rather render Swift obsolete if you reach your goal?
No, I won't say that. I don't think that. I don't think the idea is really to compete or at this level. What we see is blockchain is there to address a need. And the way that we are using this technology is also address a series of inefficiencies. Mm-hmm. And what we see, for instance, in the current use cases that you hear in the market, such as the global remittance or even the corporate-to-corporate flows, so the banks are thinking how they can address a requirements and change the experience of their customers. If the technology like blockchain and Ripple is more appropriate to bring that to the customers, that's the choice of the customers at the end. That's the way that we see it.
Sure, so absolutely for a bank it makes sense to be already connected to Swift and not turn it off switch to Ripple, but rather have both, of course. But maybe only for a certain period, and in the end it turns out, well, why would I need Swift at all if Ripple has enough reach to serve any payment corridor, I would...
Of course. Yeah. That remains, as I mentioned, the choice of the market.
Yeah, okay. So, as a bank, why should I start using Ripple?
Well, typically the banks that we are discussing and the banks that adhere or, we are on board, the use case is around two area. The first area is how you can generate a new revenue opportunities and keep the market share. Mm-hmm. Providing on-demand real-time experience in the cross-border space while that the internal domestic systems are already moving to the real-time, it will become a reality in the future, you see. So I think that's really where we see the more pioneer or advanced banks that have invested in Ripple are thinking. And secondly, I think is around cost efficiencies. We know that the banks are under threat by cost regulation. There are a series of things that push banks to look at and renew themselves. And we see that by using the distributed ledger technology of Ripple, you clearly can bring lots of operational efficiencies around some of the defects management, reconciliation, because you are in a workflow that is has designed for instant transfer of value. So you see, in certain cases, this could go up to 70% in terms of the efficiency gain. So that's basically where we see banks create their business case and actually get the buy-in of their top management.
And certain cases means certain payment corridors, like is it more efficiency gain for specific currencies or corridors?
Yeah, I think if you look at, for instance, in a general context, when you look at the cross-border space, in a normal term, you have 3 to 5 days sometimes, even for a very liquid currency. So you have, that means that you have many intermediaries in the chain and the cost that's associated to these intermediaries. What we see is in the remittance side, in the global remittance and the exotic corridor like India, Middle East, China, Brazil, these corridors clearly are the subject for the remittance users in order to benefit from this more economic model of transacting value.
Okay. And Ripple has gained a lot of traction, has grown its network a lot. Recently, 100 financial institutions were announced on the Ripple net. However, we don't see a large German bank so far. And do you think there are specific barriers in Germany for not joining or hesitating?
You're right. We have more than 100 customers, which is a combination of both banks and payment service providers, and also now corporates. I think to your point, Germany is a complex market. You have these three pillars of banking industry, and a wide number of banks present. Yeah. This regional as well aspect, it's a quite, I should say, complex financial industry version. We do have, of course, Raiffeisen Bank, which is the 100% subsidiary of the DZ Bank, that is collaborating with us, and they had a very new experience with the corridor of Canada and Germany. And we are in discussion with many of your banks, actually. And I think, it's again question of changing and probably other priorities that we see that we feel that today regulation is very much present in the banking space. But we are very confident that Germany will move as well ahead with Ripple.
Okay, so for a German bank, what would you recommend to start with?
Well, the way that we work is really trying to address an efficiencies or a problem that bring a return of invest faster to the bank. That's the way that we, because we are no longer in an experimental world, because our network is live since last year. So finding the right use case with the banks, thinking about how this will become a new business model and the change of what they service to their customers, that I think is where we are working hard with many German banks.
Okay, so it's really, you can calculate and say it's really you get a return on invest and not just exploring the space.
Exactly. I think that's where we see the trust is coming more and more, is that the transaction are live. We have SEB, for instance, that has been transacting very close now to 1 billion US value of the USD. This is very important for a new network like us, because this shows the confidence that a bank like a Scandinavian bank has to such a new network. And we are seeing actually the good result and the impact that this is coming bringing to the market.
Okay. As a final question, if everything turns out well, do you see XRP as the global reserve asset of the future?
Well, I think the XRP has been designed for the transfer of value. The creator actually that designed it in the beginning, and that's how it was gifted to Ripple in order to create a new ecosystem around that. So for us, XRP is a key component of this new ecosystem that we are creating. Now, how this will be used by the community, what we see today is that payment service providers have more facility in using that. They are piloting that because probably the regulation is not quite yet strict for them. But the way that we see that is probably not the large banks that they have lots of liquidity, but for a medium size and smaller size bank that they don't have this amount of liquidity and they don't want to tie up their capitals in the foreign currencies, this is a real solution because you can use XRP as a bridge currency. You can get exchange to any new currencies that you want by using XRP. So I think, yes, for us, building XRP and a healthy ecosystem around XRP is very important.
Okay. Thanks, Marianne.
Thanks
a lot.
Thank you.